Over here on the guitar, Mr. Mike Scott.
Thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you very much. I'll be drinking lots of vodka at the end of the night. Just want to let you know. Apologize now, okay?
Lot of you don't do it while we're here. So, Mikey, you were on the road with, let me see now, who you out with now? This guy's out with Justin Timberlake right now. Isn't that something, man?
He don't give a flying shit.
I know, that's cool. That's cool. Rihanna, but we got you here right now. That's all that matters to me.
I ain't gonna lie, when I first got in the band, I was like, which one is Justin Timberlake?
Dude, I remember, I played on the Donnie Marie television show in America, and I remember when Justin came on when he was in MC. He was like, he was just a little boy, man. The cool thing about Mike is he spent 15 years with Prince, man. You gotta tell us a little bit about him.
Hey, yeah, I ain't gonna lie. 15 years, on and off, he fired me. He fired me every couple of years. Pulled me right back in. It was quite the experience. I have so many stories to tell, I can't tell them all. But we'll tell you too. A lot of people have been asking about this cuff. And Prince dropped this on stage one night while we were performing, and it tumbled by my feet. I picked it up, you know, put it in my pocket, and we finished the show. After the show, I went and I said, oh, you dropped this. He said, oh, sorry, keep it, it's yours. So, this is Prince. Hey, but you know what? Prince like to play jokes, man. These guys said earlier, Ricky said earlier, Prince was a jokester. He like, he'd say, hey, how you doing? How you feeling today? He said, I feel my hands. How do you feel? How do you feel? You know, he like to play jokes. Told you earlier, he threw my guitar.
He was the funniest guy you knew, man.
He was funny. He had lots of jokes. But you know what? I got a joke on him, and I never got to tell him. I told these guys, and I'm going to share this with you all. And he went to his grave not knowing this. We were playing in London, and his rig, all guitar players know, we had three racks full of shit, just processors, Eventide, and power amps and all this. And at 220 voltage, his tech was having a problem with a buzz. And they were saying over the microphone, Prince is on the way, the man's on the move. So we trying to get the buzz out, because Prince didn't want no freaking buzz, especially in his guitar. You do this, if Prince did that, you got fined $1,000. And it would throw your whole night off, especially if you did it twice. So the tech was trying to get the buzz out. They're like, the boss is pulling up 5 minutes. Prince's rig went poof, whole shit went up in flames. And the tech just fell down to his knees. And they were like, what are we gonna do? He's pulling up. They were like, hold Prince. You know, we could hear him through the walkies because all the crew had on walkies. They were hold him 5 minutes. They're like, what are we gonna do? Shit, what are we gonna do? We were all standing there. I said, plug me into my guitar, because he only plays the first song, and then he doesn't play the next six songs. I said, plug him into my guitar. And they just rolled out a little amp for me, and they plugged him in. Man's coming up the steps. He's walking to the stage, he puts his guitar on. We start grooving, we jamming. He walks over to me and says, my guitar sounds amazing tonight, doesn't it? I want to say, yeah, but then you play it through my shit. That's why your guitar sounds amazing. But he went to his grave, and how ironic that night, he would come over and say that, my guitar sounds amazing tonight. He went to his grave never knowing that his shit went up in flames.
Guess what, Mike? He knows now.
$1,000.
$1,000.
$5,000. It would probably make my rig blow up right now. Just so. Hey, look, y'all, Prince was a blessing to us all. He was a musical genius. He was a mentor. He was a teacher. He was so many things to all of you and to us, because each one of us, he touched you all with his music, but he made us better musicians. Each one of us came in there a great musician, and we left him a much, much greater musician, because he pushed us so hard, and We learned so much from that brother. He was, God only made one Prince, and he's gone, but his music will live but through you all and through us. So one thing Prince used to do that we all loved, he would just jam. He just, like we're doing tonight, we just jamming up, y'all. We don't know what the fuck we're doing. But except for the songs that we did earlier. The rest of them, we just having fun. And I hope you all enjoy it. Let's give St. Paul a big round of applause. The basement, a big round of applause for having us, and we want to thank the crew and staff here for such a great time. We've had a great time. Big round of applause, man. But one thing Prince used to do, we would jam. So we've been jamming. Let's jam some more. To like to marinate this song, y'all, when he was in the mood. Y'all keep going.
Purple rain.
big job too. Say you want to leave her, but you couldn't do to make up your mind.
Give it up one more time for St. Paul and the Minneapolis Funk All-Stars.